It's good. Amen. Hallelujah. I want to let everyone know this morning we got an updated version of Easy Worship, and the words won't be there for the songs today, hopefully tonight. But let's go ahead and let's stand and let's worship the Lord today, for He is worthy to be praised. Amen. Thank you, Jesus.
My eyes on your faithfulness.
Hearts with praise. Let's enter into his courts with praise. Hallelujah. 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 We worship you, Lord. We praise you, Lord. We honor you, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You are the great King. Hallelujah. We praise his name. Oh, let's just praise his name today. He is worthy to be praised. We love you, Jesus. Hallelujah. 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 Glory to God. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus.
Worship the King. Worship the King. We are in his presence. When we seek his face, glory fills his place as we worship the King. Worship the King, worship the King.
your word says you inhabit our praises, O God. Oh Lord, we desire your presence. We desire to be in your presence, O God. Oh, bless us, O God, today. Hallelujah. We thank you for your presence. We thank you for your presence. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. There's not a greater place to be than in the presence of the Lord. There's not a greater place to be than loving him, worshiping him, allowing him to move, minister to us. Praise God. There's a wonderful presence of the Lord here this morning. We love you, Jesus. Hallelujah. 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 Glory to God. Glory to God. It is where he is worthy to be praised. We love him. The reason we gather together to worship him is because we love him. Let our love go to Jesus today. Let's let him know what we think of him. Praise God. He is our everything. He is our God. He is our Father. He is our best friend. He cares about us more than anyone or anything will ever care about us. Amen. We worship him today. We love you, Jesus. One day we'll spend eternity with him. Hallelujah. But until then, we're going to praise him. We're going to worship him. Hallelujah. We're going to do his will. We're going to walk in his ways. Praise God. We're going to fall in love with his word. We're going to meditate upon his law. Praise God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We love you, Jesus. We love you, Jesus. We're going to be his hands and his feet, and his eyes and his mouth. Praise God. We love you, Jesus.
A sweet,
oh, yes,
anointing in this sanctuary.
Praise God.
There is a stillness.
Hallelujah.
In the
atmosphere. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Come.
Praise God. here today. He's moving in this place today. He's touching hearts. Hallelujah. We worship you, O God. We praise you, O God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We glorify your name with our worship, O God. Oh, blessed be the name of Jesus. Blessed be the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. 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 Glory to God. Let's take a moment. Let's take a moment and worship him. Oh, let's just worship him today. We love you, Jesus. Oh, hallelujah. We praise you, oh God. Everything is in your hands. You sit upon the throne. You are the King of all kings. Everything is, every authority in this world, every authority in the unseen world is subject to you. Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah. We praise you, God. We praise your name. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Praise God. It's good to be in the house of the Lord today. It's good to worship him. Amen. As things loosen up with in society and things, stores, different businesses opening slowly, I'm looking forward to the day when we can all gather together at church. Amen. We're going to keep praying for wisdom. We'll err on caution side. It'll be a few weeks. We should know a little bit more, but let's just keep on praying, keep on loving God, keep on worshiping, gather our families together, praise his name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Don't forsake the appointed time. Amen. We'll be having church again tonight at 6 p.m. Hopefully we'll be live streaming on that one. But the God is good. Amen. And he is worthy to be praised. Praise God. Where two or more are gathered in my name, he said, I will be there. Amen. I will be there. Praise God. Hallelujah. And that's the reason we gather together. So Jesus will be here with us. Amen. Praise God. Praise God. I want to talk this morning about God's anointing. And I'm going to go to the book of Acts in chapter 19. I'm going to read verses 11 through 20. Praise God. Praise God. Acts chapter 19, verse 11 through 20. It says, and God wrought special miracles by the hands of Paul, so that from his body were brought unto the sick. And it's good to be in the house of the Lord. We have an account here of Paul and the power of God. And Paul was a man anointed by God in a mighty way. Amen. And the works that were done by Paul could not be done by just anyone, because it was the anointing of God upon Paul that was the source of his power. Amen. Now let me remind us here today, the anointing of God is not just for Paul, and it's not just for the apostles, just like the infilling of the Holy Ghost is not just for Paul and the apostles. It's for all of us. Amen. When you are filled with God's Spirit, you have an anointed God from God. Amen. And we can be victorious in every situation because we have the anointing of God. The anointing is God's enablement. It's God's power that helps us live a life for God. Now, if you walk by the flesh and not by the Spirit, you will not have the anointing of God. And the seven sons of Sceva found out real quick that when they tried casting a devil out in Jesus' name, the Spirit was very clear and says, "Hey, I know Jesus. And hey, I know Paul, but who are you?" And they had no power over that spirit. Why? Because they had no anointing. The anointing of God doesn't enable us to live our life our way. The anointing of God enables us to live our life the way God has intended us to live our life. Amen? Praise God. In other words, the anointing of God doesn't serve your agenda. The anointing of God is there to serve God's agenda. Praise God. God sends his anointing to us. Amen. And with that, he brings glory to himself. Amen. The glory of God is what the anointing is for, to show God's power. Amen. The anointing will enable you to do things you could never do before. Everyone has probably felt it. You're talking to someone about the Lord, and all of a sudden, the words start just flowing. You don't even know where these words are coming from, but you're speaking things you don't even realize where it's coming from. You're quoting scripture and you don't even know where that scripture is coming from. Amen. If you've ever taught a Bible study or taught the Sunday school, a Sunday school or youth class or whatever, you probably know what the anointing is. You probably have felt that anointing and just visiting with someone on the job or whatever. Amen. One preacher I heard put it like this: when you're operating under God's anointing, God adds his super to your natural, giving you supernatural power. Amen. Praise God. Now, the reason some people can make it through things that would destroy others is because of the anointing of God. Amen. It is because of God's anointing that you can stand when others will fall. It is because God has blessed you with his Spirit, blessed you with his anointing. Amen. And that anointing of God is the strength of God. And the strength of God in you doesn't depend on how strong you are physically. Has nothing to do with that. The most weak, the most fragile person can be mighty under the anointing of God. I heard a testimony years ago of some bikers that were won to the Lord by this little old lady, because she went to a place where they were, where nobody was, everybody else was scared to go, but she wasn't. And she continued to go to these bikers and continued to tell them about Jesus. Amen. And she won those bikers to the Lord, praise God, by a little old lady that was not scared to witness about the power of Christ, amen, and the salvation of Christ. See, God's anointing has nothing to do with physical strength. God's anointing will even make you surprise yourself at times, amen. Praise God. Did I really say that? Hallelujah. See, God's anointing can really work in your life. It'll surprise you. The answer to you know, all that when you're under the power of God and you're speaking things you don't even, you know, don't know where they're coming from, and you're bold about it, it is because God has placed his anointing upon you. Praise God. Amen. And one of the main things we need to understand about the anointing of God is that it is not us, but it is God's power. Amen. Praise God. Samson was a man that thought he had it all under control, and he was under God's anointing, and he was a strong man, and the Philistines were scared of this man. But he told his secret to this woman that he thought he loved, and this woman, of course, we know the secret was his hair. She cut his hair off, and you know what happened? The anointing of God left him. But what I want to point out here is Samson didn't know that the anointing of God had left him. Samson thought he was doing it in his own strength. And in Judges 16:20, when the Philistines came upon him, it says this in verse 20. It says, "And she said, 'The Philistines are upon you.'" That was Delilah telling him. And so he awoke from his sleep and said, "I'll go out as before at other times, and I'll shake myself free." But he did not know that the Lord had departed from him. See, the Lord had departed from Samson, and he didn't even realize the Lord had departed from him. Why? Because he thought it was in his own strength that he was doing the acts that he was doing. But God stepped back from him and said, "Okay, if that's what you think, go ahead. I will show you what is really the truth." There was no anointing. There's no power. If you could go and pull that rock out of Goliath's forehead and look at it, you'd see it was just an ordinary rock. If we could bring David here today and say, "I want to see that bicep that you threw that rock with, or your hand. I want to see that weapon, that sling that you used." You'd find out there was nothing special about the sling, and there was nothing special about David, and there was nothing special about the rock. In fact, David was just the littlest of all. If you would have put him against the warriors in the Israeli army, you would not have picked David to fight Goliath. See, the thing that was special about David is God's anointing, amen? It's God's anointing that is special about us. Praise God. What separates us from the other people of the world is God's anointing power. Praise God. Hallelujah. And here's a little secret. You don't have to be strong. In fact, God's anointing, his power, his strength is showing through our weaknesses. 2 Corinthians 12:7. Here's Paul, a man, the great man of God, and he says this, and God gives him a thorn in his flesh, and he says, "Unless I should be exalted above measure through the abundance of the revelations, there was given to me a thorn in the flesh, the messenger of Satan, to buffet me, lest I should be exalted above measure." He says, "For this thing I besought the Lord three times, that it might depart." And he said, the Lord said unto Paul, "My grace is sufficient for thee, for my strength is made perfect in weakness." Praise God. And then Paul, he just turns around and says, "Most gladly, therefore, will I rather glory in my infirmities, that the power of Christ may rest upon me." Praise God. We know that we are anointed when God takes our flimsy, frail weaknesses and turns them into his strengths. Amen. Praise God. Why does Brother Dixon's knees hurt so bad until he gets beside this behind this pulpit? And then the pain goes away. It is because of God's anointing upon him. Praise God. Paul was so anointed by God. He was a man that was just dripping with anointment, so much so that he made the ministry look easy. He would pray over cloths. They would take it to the sick, and the sick would be healed. If you don't know my story, the first 7 years of my marriage, I spent not in church, and yet my wife was praying for me. The church was praying for me. She had a cloth anointed with oil and prayed over by her pastor and his assistant, and she put it under my pillow. I didn't know it. I didn't know what was going on, but she said, "I got really bad then." You know why? Because the devil doesn't like the anointing of God. Oh, hallelujah. But guess what? It worked, because here I am today, some 20 years later. Praise God. Still serving the King of Kings. Still loving Jesus. Amen. God's anointing power works. Amen. Those seven sons of Sceva, Jewish priests named Sceva, they were his sons. They basically tried to perform an exorcism. They were drawn to the power of the Holy Ghost. They wanted the power of the Holy Ghost. Their problem was they had no connection with Jesus. They thought, if Paul can do it, we can do it. But what happened? When they tried casting out the demons called them out. Hey, I know Jesus. Hey, I know Paul. But I don't know you. See, the anointing of God cannot be imitated. It cannot. You cannot just go through the motions. You either have God's anointing or you don't. You either have repented or you haven't. You either have been filled with God's Spirit or you haven't. You have either been baptized in Jesus' name or you haven't. There are many people today that want to live for God in a distant way. They want to have God's blessings. They want to have God's peace in their life. They want to have God's hope in their life. But they don't want to do what it takes to have the victory in their life. Show me a person that has victory, and I'll show you a person that has submitted and surrendered to God. Amen. And his word. Praise God. Show me a person that has victory. I'll show you a person that has faced a lot of trials and yet has been determined to serve God through those trials and came out on the other side. Praise God. Some people think it's just so easy just to attend church and everything's going to be okay. Just watch church on the TV. It'll be okay. I'll have God's anointing in my life. Wrong answer. You see, you want God's anointing? You have to be subject to God. You have to submit yourself to God. For one, you're going to have to turn from your sin. You're going to have to repent. You're going to have to, in your heart, no, I'm done with that life of sin. For two, you're going to have to be baptized in the wonderful name of Jesus for the remission of your sin. For three, you're going to have to surrender to God and let him fill you with his Spirit, and their evidence of tongues will come forth. Praise God. Amen. And then you have to live his word. He has to become more important to you than anyone. Praise the Lord. He has to become more important to you than your family. He has to become more important to you than your money. He has to become more important to you than your 401k. Amen. As Brother Votaw put it, he has to be more important to you than the Super Bowl. Praise God. Amen. Victory comes with a struggle. And victory comes when we allow God to let us help us overcome the old man, overcome the flesh. When you see someone with victory in their life, just know that victory didn't come easy. It came at a price. It came with sacrifice. But it's worth it. It's worth it. And as long as you serve Jesus, you will walk in victory. Here's a good point to know. You don't need everyone that you know to be saved. You don't need everyone in your family to surrender to Jesus to have the victory. Moses stepped in front of Pharaoh, the greatest authority in the known world at that time, and he stepped in front of Pharaoh and took on a whole nation, him and God. He didn't have the Israelis behind him. He didn't have the people of Israel behind him saying, "Go, Moses, go." He didn't have that. He had God. Amen. Praise God. Elijah stepped in front of 450 prophets of Baal. He didn't have anybody on their side. He tried to get Israel to make a choice. They were quiet. They were silent. They didn't say a word. But yet God was with him. Who won? The one that was anointed by God. Amen. If God be for us, who can be against us? Praise God. You know, I just read about Jehoshaphat. Three different nations came against him. The Ammonites came, the Moabites came, and the people from Mount Seir came. And Jehoshaphat, he was namely good. Namely, he did what was right. He had a few mistakes in his life. But in this instant, he did what was right. Jehoshaphat, seeing this army come, this multitude, this massive, massive army. And what did he do? He called Judah. And all the people of Judah, he said, "We're going to pray and we're going to fast because you know what? I'm scared. I don't know what's going on." And they called upon the Lord. Amen. And it says the men and the women and their children all were praying. Praise God. And the word of the Lord came through a man in the congregation. And that word was simple. It said, "Stand still and see the salvation of the Lord. Praise God. Praise God. Hallelujah. And to make things even crazier, on the day of the battle, Jehoshaphat says, hey, you soldiers, stay right there. We're putting our praise singers in front here. We're going to put our ladies and our men that are praising the Lord. And they go out to battle against his massive army with a bunch of praise singers. And they're praising the Lord and they're worshiping the Lord. And what happens is just totally insane. The enemy begins to kill each other. And what blows my mind is it says they killed each other until there wasn't one of them left. I'm talking about hundreds of thousands of men. It says not one escaped. They killed each other. Praise God. It took Judah 3 days to take all the riches and all the spoils that that army brought with them. And after 3 days of spoiling all those dead men, taking all the gold and all the silver and all the jewels from them, they went to Jerusalem and they had a praise party. Oh, hallelujah. They praised the Lord with all of their heart. They praised the God of Abraham. They praised the God of Jacob and Isaac. Praise God. We have an enemy that wants to destroy us. He's watching us every day. He's devising plans on how to take us down. But we have a God that is watching over us. Amen. That is why I wanted to teach on the armor of God last Wednesday. Because we have to be ready for the battle. We have to be battle ready. Praise God. The devil knows who you are. He knows your weaknesses. That is why I asked the question last week, do you know your own weaknesses? And if you don't, you better figure out what they are. Why? Because you need God to help you shore up that area. Because if you don't let God shore up that area and you don't have some accountability in that area, Satan is going to come in and he's going to use that weakness against you. You have to know who you are and you have to know who's going to help you. It is the great I am. Praise God. We do not have time to be insecure. We don't have time for low self-esteem. We don't have time for pity parties. We don't have time to dabble in sin. He is planning his attack on you right now as I speak. He tracks the anointing. Believe me. Satan knows where the anointing of God is. He knows it. And I'll prove it to you. He knows. He's aware of what God wants to do in your life. He may not know how God's going to do it, but he's aware of what God wants to do. And the reason he's fighting some of us so hard is because he realizes that if we know who we are, that we could shake up his kingdom. Oh, hallelujah. He's aware of the anointing in your life. I want to read Job chapter 1, verse 6 and 7. I put it in the New Living Testament so we can understand. Keep reading that, you're going to read, if you keep going down, where God asked Satan, have you considered my servant Job? Now, here's what I want us to see. Satan didn't say, Job, who's that? Job, no, I haven't heard of him. No, Satan knew that God had a hedge of protection around Job. He knew who Job was, and he knew God had a hedge of protection against Job. He knows who you are. He knows where you live, and he knows that God has a hedge of protection about you. Praise God. We cannot be preoccupied with our own weaknesses or insecurities. You might be thinking, Lord, I'm not ready, I'm not able, I'm not good enough. I don't want you to think that way. You need to think about who you are. I'm a child of the King. I'm anointed of the Lord. Amen. Praise God. And God has a hedge of protection again around me. Amen. Hallelujah. The enemy's not worried about what you can't do. He's worried about what you can do. When you realize who you are in the Lord, he's worried about what you can do. He is fighting the anointing that's on your life. He's not fighting you. He knows if he can get the anointing off your life, he has you. He's aware of who you are. He'll attack your fears. Coronavirus got you fearful. He'll attack that. And the more you fear something, the stronger it becomes. See, we're in a fight. The battle that most of us are fighting is for our souls and for our family's souls. We have to lay aside our fears. We have to fight with the ability and the knowledge of who we are. We are the anointed of the Lord. Amen. We have to lay aside our fears and pray. We have to lay aside our fears and worship the Lord. Praise God. Lay aside our fears and just worship, praise his name. Thank you, Jesus. We have to submit to God. Amen. And the book of James tells us, submit therefore to God. Resist the devil and he will flee from you. That word resist means pull away from, pull back from. When the devil comes against you, you just resist him. I am going to stand. I will oppose you, devil, in the name of Jesus. Amen. You can just go ahead and tell the devil who you are. I'm a blood washed, sanctified, praise God, Holy Ghost filled child of the living God. Amen. Hallelujah. I got a long lineage of people in my past. Moses and Aaron and David and Daniel, Paul and Peter, Jesus even, praise God. God called me from nothingness into what? Greatness. Everything that we are is by the grace of God. Amen. As long as we know that, we are going to be okay. The devil cannot stand against God's power. He can stand against you, but he cannot stand against the power of God. We are washed in his blood, church. The remission of sins, praise God. We are empowered by the Holy Ghost. We have the word of God, amen. In 2 Timothy 2:19, it says, Nevertheless, the foundation of God stands sure, having this seal. Calling on the name of Jesus. I got healed by calling on the name of Jesus. I got filled when I called on the name of Jesus. Praise God. We have that name, the name of Jesus. Philippians 2, 9 through 11 says, wherefore God also has highly exalted him. Jesus is my chain breaker. Jesus is my mind helper. Amen. Jesus is the reason I don't go insane. Jesus is everything. See, the name of Jesus worked for Paul in the book of Acts. You think that has changed? That has not changed. The name of Jesus still holds all the power. Everyone who is in a battle should shout the name of Jesus. Everyone who is in trouble should shout the name of Jesus. Everyone who is discouraged should call on the name of Jesus. Everyone who is sick should call on the name of Jesus. If you need a breakthrough in your life, call on the name of Jesus. If you need a mountain moved in your life, call on the name of Jesus. If you need help in any way, call on the name of Jesus. Amen. Praise God. Sister Tammy, if you'd come. God's word is always going to be here. We will always have this word, church. This word is for an eternity. It will never go away. God's word is our salvation. God's word is our power. We have anointing through the Spirit of God and His word. You are anointed by God, every single one of you. Amen. Why don't we stand today and let's worship Him. Know that you are the anointed of God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We praise your wonderful name, God. We worship your holy name. Thank you, Jesus. Help us to know that we are anointed. Help us to know we are.
I said anointed, all I need.
Sing it to him. Let's just go to the Lord in prayer today. Let's let him know, God, we want your anointing. We desire that anointing. God, we come before you today, Lord. We love you and we honor you, God. Lord, your wonderful anointing, God, let us remember who we are. Let your anointing fall upon us, God, in everything we do, at our workplace, God, in our homes, God, wherever we go to the store, let your anointing go with us, Lord. We love you. We honor you, Lord. We praise you. In Jesus' name, praise God.